Hey, how you doing there again, folks? Me again, of course, Brandon Wenzel. Come back at you, another offering off my sampler platter. Yes, indeed, folks, sampler video series of videos I've been doing for a little while. I go over there, try out food and drink items. I eat stuff, I drink stuff, then, folks, I'm going to talk about stuff. I'm going to let you know all that you need to know about, hopefully delicious stuff that, Tom, I'm doing this, folks. I'm not going to lie. This was not my intended review today. I had a whole other item that I was going to review. Didn't end up happening, so we're just going to make do. But we'll get to that. Folks, it's super simple format. I'm going to go over there and try out food and or drink items for you. Whilst I'm doing so, I'm going to yammer on about it for a bit. Whilst I'm doing all that, I'm inside my truck. And whilst I'm doing all that, folks, I'm wearing a super cool shirt. Folks, when I wear super cool shirts, I always like to highlight super cool shirt. What super cool shirt am I wearing for today, folks? Well, it happens to be my, boom, my Sega Dreamcast shirt. Got the whole sort of diagram style. I love this shirt. It's very cool. If you're unfamiliar with the Sega Dreamcast, I don't even know if you're old enough to be watching my content, if that's the case. But, no, the Sega Dreamcast was the swan song console from the company Sega. Of course, Sega is famous mostly these days for Sonic the Hedgehog and, you know, kind of that end of their franchises. But they used to make video game systems back in them thar days when I was but a lad. And, unfortunately, despite the reputation of the Dreamcast as being what sunk Sega, that was definitely not the case. Sega sunk Sega, and the Dreamcast was basically their last-ditch effort. And unfortunately, just circumstances, it just was too far gone. But the Dreamcast, despite that, was and still is a really great system. It has a small but excellent library of games. It was really trying to push things. I can't say enough good things about it. Good things about it. It's still one of my favorite video game systems to this day. Still one of my favorite libraries of games to this day. If you ever have the opportunity, get yourself, you know, play yourself some Dreamcast. It's a really good system. But anyway, what am I trying for you today, folks? What are we doing here? Why is it not what I intended to review? So, I went over there. I'd gotten a number of people, my friend Nate and some other folks, and I'd seen, you know, some ads and stuff for it. Talking about new item from Taco Bell, some sort of Cheez-It Crunchwrap collaboration. It was like, all right, that's perfect. That's exactly the type of shit that I review. So I went over there, I hopped on out to my local Taco Bell, and they didn't have it available yet. So I was like, all right. So I decided, fuck it, man, I'm still going to grab something. Might as well still review something. So, boom, it is from Taco Bell. And it is, boom, it's this. What is this? This is their Cantina Chicken Quesadilla. So this is part of their Cantina menu that they brought back, I think last month, I want to say. And they have like a taco available, they have a burrito, and they also have a quesadilla. I've already reviewed the burrito, and I did mention at the time that this is actually sort of a return to form because the Cantina menu was a thing, well, kind of. It was a sort of premium line that Taco Bell tried for like a number of years, and then they took it off the menu, and now they're kind of bringing it back. So, sure, why the fuck not? So let's go ahead first and foremost. Let's get a thing for the thing. It looks like this. Let's, you know what, here. Let's, can we get a cheese pull? Can we get a cheese pull? Can we get a cheese? Sure, something like that. But anyway, let's go ahead and let's give it a shot. I mean, that's good. You know, I mean, Taco Bell quesadillas are one of those things that for me, they're a little bit of a guilty pleasure. Like, they're nowhere near as good as proper quesadillas. They're not even close. They're kind of a cheat quesadilla. They're like some shit that even I could probably make realistically. But there is something to them because, I mean, at the end of the day, you know, you got the tostilla, tostada, whatever the hell you want to call it. You got that, you know, you got some cheese, you got some meat. It's a pretty simple thing overall. You know, so, I mean, fundamentally, it's pretty similar to their normal chicken quesadilla, but it's just got a little, little something extra, a little extra zing to it because of the canteen element. It's nice. Yeah, it's just, it's, again, very similar to the normal chicken quesadilla, but personally I think a little bit better just because a little bit extra. Yeah, I mean, look, Taco Bell is what Taco Bell is, but credit where it's due, that's just tasty. Like, there's nothing that I dislike about that. It's just melty cheese, chicken. I mean, like I said, there's definitely a little extra zing from the cantina aspect to it. Gives it a little bit of a little extra zip and a little maybe kind of extra freshness. It gives it a little extra dimension. I think that's what I like about it. But we're not done because our cantina items also come with some, boom, avocado verde salsa. So let's go ahead. We'll go over there and we'll also do this. We'll kind of pop a little bit on one of these. Whoa, it's starting to pop out already. All right, and let's go ahead. I mean, I do like the avocado salsa. It does, I will say, it actually does taste like the elements that it's supposed to. You genuinely get sort of a fairly even mix of an avocado flavor. It's a mild avocado flavor, but, you know, against everything else. And then you get that, you know, sort of salsa verde flavor, where it has a very, you know, it's got a little heat to it, not much, but it's got a little heat to it. But it's also got, like, a vibrancy to it, you know? It's one of the things that's so nice about, like, verde salsa. And yeah, I mean, the only thing is, especially against the quesadilla, well, quesadilla is a thin little thing. The salsa really does pretty much take over. You don't get a lot of the rest of it after that. But it is a nice salsa. It's tasty. And I think it does kind of work with the cantina items, since they are trying to, again, kind of be a little bit more quasi-high-end, I guess, a little bit, you know, so that Taco Bell isn't just a one-trick pony. They can do a little something. Yeah, it's nice. I enjoyed the cantina chicken burrito. Lo and behold, I enjoy the cantina chicken quesadilla. But yeah, two questions have to be asked. Would I get it again? Would I recommend it? In this case, it really is kind of less, because, like, I like it. For me, it's less an issue of, you know, would I get it again because I, you know, do I like it or not? More so, would I get this again over the burrito, which I already liked? And honestly, I will say, I think that there's pros and cons to both. I think overall, I would get it again, and I think I probably would recommend it. In comparison to the burrito, it's a much thinner experience. Because the burrito, of course, is a burrito. It's a big-ass thing filled with stuff. It's a good time. With this, you know, it's a little bit more ethereal. But it's still really flavorful. It's still really tasty. And it's kind of, I can almost kind of do both. Even though it's essentially, or if not entirely, the same flavors on display, it really does go to show that the format makes a huge difference, because with the burrito, there's just more going on. Overall, I personally feel like there's just more going on in the eating experience. With these, you get a decent amount of flavor out of them, and there is, you know, like I said, kind of a guilty pleasure aspect to them, but it is a much more, it's kind of, you know, similar to their actual size. It's a thin experience, you know, but there is something to be said for that too. It's a very direct eating experience. So it is kind of a thing where, like, I could honestly see myself maybe getting the burrito and getting these as, like, my side and not feeling like I'm just doubling up on all the same things. I do think the eating experience kind of plays in, and I think that both are good in their own ways. If I'm recommending them, again, it's kind of, would I recommend them over the burrito? And again, I think that it really does depend on what you want out of it. I think the burrito is just, there's just more to it. You know, it's a more filling, more filling eating experience, more dimension to it. But in some ways, the quesadilla, it has its charm, you know, and I feel like it's one of those things, if you already enjoy the quesadillas that Taco Bell offers, I personally think this is just kind of an slightly elevated version of those, and honestly, one that I prefer over their normal ones. So yeah, I mean, I would still recommend it for what it is. I don't think it's going to go over there and wow you or anything like that, but I think it's good, and if nothing else, the salsa verde, the avocado salsa verde is a nice add-on. And personally, I think they should just keep that around as an option, I'm just saying. But yeah, I mean, nothing about this has transcended my expectations, but at the same time, it has met my level of enjoyment that I expected, and I'm happy about that. But anyway, five things before I get out of here. Have yourself a great rest of your day, spectacular rest of your week, monumental rest of the month, stupendous rest of your year. Folks, go with their episodes are truly proper quesadilla-tastic rest of your life, man. Because again, like, proper quesadillas are a wonderful, beautiful thing. Taco Bell ones should not be a substitute. They shouldn't even call themselves quesadillas. But final two things. Number one, try to bring some positivity into the world. It's not always possible. It is, however, always appreciated. But what you do if can't do all the time, I know I can't do all the time. Here's what you're going to do, folks. You're going to try not to be an asshole. Folks, not always the easiest thing in the world to not be an asshole. Trust me. I know it. I live it. I'm out there every day with you in it. Life can be stressful, stressful and frustrating. Life can be stressful and frustrating, and sometimes just filled with bullshit. And folks, when we have to deal with said bullshit, it's important that we go over there whenever possible. Take a step back. Try to mitigate the level of assholishness in our lives. Hopefully, do better for ourselves and for those around us. Very final thing, folks, do the thing. Whatever the thing is for you, that's what I want you to go out and do. Folks, have you ever played a Sega Dreamcast? I mean, again, you know, at the time I'm doing this, I'm 37, slowly reaching 38. Yeah. And I don't, you know, the Dreamcast kind of came and went. There are people even within my own generation who never really experienced the Dreamcast. But it demands a certain level of respect. I mean, for fuck's sake, the release date was $99.99. And when it came out, it literally broke sales records. Like, it was a holy shit thing. Only problem, well, there were a lot of problems. But then, you know, literally a year after that, the PS2 came out and was just like, I'm gonna curb stomp everything. And, you know, I so wish Sega had kept making systems after that. I know why they couldn't do it. It just wasn't gonna happen. But if you have any memories, and it doesn't even have to be the Dreamcast, if you have any gaming memories or anything like that of whatever system, feel free to comment them. I do love some video games. Thank you.